One day, 250 years ago, a young teacher named Abraham Tremblay was walking through a field, and he came to a pond, looked in, and there in the water he saw this thing. It was very little, with wavy tentacles on top and a tube-like body. And just to see what would happen, he cut it in half. Much to his surprise, instead of dying on the spot, the animal grew back into two full-sized adults. So he did it again. The same thing happened. And again, this animal just wouldn't die. The hydra, that's what it's called, has extraordinary powers of regeneration, almost as if it's built not to die ever, which is ridiculous because everything dies, we assume. In science, however, you don't assume, you check. So, in the 1990s, a curious young scientist, Daniel Martinez, having heard that hydras go on and on and on, decided to do an experiment. He gathered a bunch of hydra from a pond in Long Island, New York, put them in some tanks where he could keep an eye on them, and he thought, all right, I'm going to wait until I see them die naturally. And hydra do die. You take them out of water, they'll shrivel up. But in a natural environment, nobody knows. So Daniel waited. First, his hydras had babies. Then a week passed. Then months passed. Meanwhile, Daniel's school year ended. He got a job out west in California. Rather than miss the death of his hydras, he put him in a cooler, traveled cross-country with his brother, and every day, wherever he was, he fed them, washed them, and he waited. A year passed. Then 2 years. 3 years. Still no deaths. 4 years out, Daniel published a science paper that said hydras apparently never die. Well, what he really said was, mortality patterns suggest lack of senescence in hydra. Now, you'd think 4 years is kind of a short term for a claim like this. I mean, a lot of us are past our fourth birthdays and we still expect to die. But here's the thing. There's a well-known pattern in nature. The sooner you have babies, the sooner you die. If you're a tiny fly, you have your babies quickly, after a couple of weeks, and you die here, after a couple of months. If you're a huge elephant, you wait 13 years to have your babies, you live for another 40 or 50 years, and then you die right around here. And this is true across the animal kingdom, except when it comes to hydra. Remember, hydra have their babies after a couple of days, so they should die after, say, a month. But Dan's hydra had lived for 4 years when he published his paper, and they are still going strong today. They've now lived for more than 8 years. That is 100 times their expected lifespan. That's like an elephant living for 5,000 years. It's like everybody else got the memo that in the end you die, but not the hydra. So what's going on? Daniel says, here's my theory. Most animals, humans and hydras both, begin with a cell, a single cell, and they multiply. In humans, our cells multiply a lot, then specialize, age, break down, and eventually they wear out, and so we die. In a hydra, the cells, A, don't specialize much. Most hydra cells are embryonic cells, and embryonic cells, like embryos, they're simple and great at staying young. So you can watch them here, moving up the tentacles, moving down to the foot, and before they have a chance to get much older, they flake off to be replaced, as you see here, by newer cells. Over 4 years, the hydra replaces all its cells, its entire body, over 60 times. Every cell in the body is completely new every 20 days. It even looks like a fountain of youth. So, for all intents and purposes, Daniel says, these animals are, and I want to use his word, immortal.